When you tell people what they want to hear, you become popular. But when you tell them what they need to hear, you become relevant. The old adage would say that leadership was based on title, position, and authority. But that's not true in today's world. You see, leadership today, it's about influence. It's about partnering with your people. It's about building relationships, adding value, creating trust, and ultimately building other leaders. What I teach leaders is the philosophies, the skills, and the approach to be relevant in today's world. What I think they missed is something that so many leaders today miss, and it's because 15 years ago, it didn't matter if you missed it. But our world has changed. What they missed is this key principle that people support what they help create. People support what they help create. Now, why is it different today? Because of social media. That's why it's different today. Now, it's not because people are on Facebook or LinkedIn or Twitter or anything else. It's because it's psychologically changed our world. You see, 15 years ago, before social media, if you didn't hold a position of leadership, you didn't have that much of a voice. And you knew that, and you were okay with that. But all of your emerging workforce that's now grown up with social media, they've always had a voice. And so as dumb as this sounds, if you hire them today, they think they have a voice tomorrow. Because psychologically, they've always had a voice. And so if we forget this idea, if we think that commitment is only at the point of implementation, we miss the boat. Commitment is at the point of creation, because then they take ownership. Think about it, as leaders, you're in the people business, right? Leadership begins and ends with people. And so your ability to build those relationships, it has to go beyond command and control. If you are in the people business, you have to be able to build amazing relationships with your people, because if culture drives business, then the relationships that you build will dramatically affect, influence, and shape the culture within your organization. I want you to remember this. You can love people without leading them, but you cannot lead people without loving them. I love that you said you want passion from your people, but here's my question. How passionate are you? Because a leader that lacks passion will have followers that lack commitment. Passion starts with you, the way you show up for your team.
What I love about leadership is that it's one of the few places where you get to truly make an impact in people's lives.
What Ty brings to stage is real-world experience on what it takes to lead in today's world. When Ty was 21, he started a company with his brother that he built to a $20 million a year business. He went on to sell that company, which got him featured in the top 40 under 40. Ty went on to found the Leadership Inc. Institute. The Institute partners with companies from startups to Fortune 500s to help take their leadership development to a whole new level. The success of Leadership Inc. recently got Ty named one of the top 10 coolest entrepreneurs in Utah.
When I'm on stage, I want to make your people laugh. I want to make them think. But specifically, I want to give them skills that are going to make them more effective as leaders.
And partnership-based leadership, what it creates transformation.
Storytelling is one of the most underrated skills in business today. And for leaders to win hearts and minds, you have to learn how to tell a great story. If you knew more about your clients, would your ability to influence them be greater? Absolutely it would. Or I have leaders who ask me, Ty, how do you motivate your employees? And my answer is always this: motivation's important, but it's overrated.
After my speech, your people will leave understanding how to be more influential, how to be more effective, but most importantly, how to be a more relevant leader.